हेलो किड्स, वेलकम वंस अगेन टू योर साइंस क्लासेस ऑफ ग्रेड फोर्थ। इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज आर चैप्टर टू, दैट वॉज फिफ्थ एंड डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। आई विल रिवाइज द सब टॉपिक्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। आई विल गिव यू अ क्विक रिकैप एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस द बुक एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। बट बिफोर दैट आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू किड्स दैट the PDF of whatever chapters I am teaching you, that we have completed one our first topic, that was about food, our basic need, and I have already uploaded the PDF of this chapter for your reading and understanding on your Snapbook app. So just please go through those Snapbook app and YouTube lecture videos regularly. Okay, don't put a break in these, because when you will understand the thing sequentially, then the understanding will be proper and correct. Okay, and soon I am going to and put the PDF of this chapter, second chapter also, on your Snapbook, so that you could better understand, you could do reading of the chapters and could have a proper understanding of all the terms. Okay, so please visit your, check your Snapbook, whatever Snapbook app homework I am placing regarding science, you have to go through that. And one more thing, you have to maintain your work, whatever written work I am giving you, very neatly and cleanly and sequentially and properly. And you can use your previous class, that was when you were in class third and there was science notebook. So might be some pages must be left in that science notebook. So kids, you can start using that notebook for completion of all these written works, whatever keywords, whatever diagram work, or fill in the blanks, true, false. Because till the date, till the time you are not having your books, you have to complete your book exercises also in your notebook only, along with the question answers. So I think Sakshi has started using the Snapbook app. She is going through it. So well done, Sakshi. So likewise, Sakshi, I want more students to come up on this online platform, whether it is a lecture video on YouTube or it is the chapter PDF or any exercises or homework being posted on the Snapbook. You have to go through it. Okay, kids, and you have to maintain your work properly, neatly and cleanly. Use sharp pencil to write. Write down questions also. Write down the chapter name, topic name also. Okay. Do your work properly with the lining work, as I have taught you in grade 3, that how you have to maintain your notebook. You can use your previous class science notebook for the completion of all these written works. Okay, so do your work neatly and cleanly, because when the school will reopen and you will come back, then these works are going to be checked. And that's why you have to maintain all these written works properly, chapter wise. Okay, with the heading of the questions and along with the solution, because each and everything we are discussing over here on YouTube video also in detail, and corresponding PDF also we are uploading on the Snapbook. So go through both these platforms and do whatever is required, whatever is being instructed to you to do. Okay. Okay. Now let's start this topic, this video, as we have already discussed this chapter, that is about fifth and digestive system. That the very first thing was that we eat food with the help of our mouth. We bite and chew food with our teeth. Yes, teeth are present inside our mouth. And we eat this food with the help of our mouth. And the cutting, biting and chewing of food is done with the help of our teeth. And these teeth are arranged, they are present in our mouth on the upper and the lower jaw. Now, how many sets of teeth are there? Human beings have two sets of teeth, temporary teeth and permanent teeth. That I have already told you that human beings, they are having two sets of teeth. First one is temporary or milk teeth. It is also known as milk teeth. And the second was permanent teeth. The baby, when it is born, does not have any teeth. By the time the child is about 2.5 years old, he or she has 20 teeth. Okay, so this first set of teeth is known as temporary or milk teeth. But these teeth, at a certain age time, at a certain time period, it starts falling off. In some children, it is about 6 years. In some, it is 7. In some, it may be 5 years. So around this age, these milk teeth, they start falling down one by one, and their place is taken over by a new set of teeth that is called permanent teeth. These permanent teeth, they are bigger than milk teeth and they are strong also. Okay, and the temporary teeth, they were 20 in number, 10 in each jaw, but the permanent teeth, they are 32 in number. Okay, 16 in the upper jaw and 16 in the lower jaw. Then we have studied about types of teeth, that on the basis of the function and their shapes and sizes, teeth are categorized into four types, that is incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Now, what was the function of incisor? It was used for biting and cutting the food. And they are sharp and flat teeth and present in front of each jaw. And there are 8 incisors, 4 in each jaw. The total number of each type of teeth also you have to remember. Like it is given 8 incisors. In total, there are 8 incisors. Then it is a common sense that 4 must be present on the upper jaw. This is the picture of an upper jaw. Likewise, a lower jaw is also present in our mouth. And 4 must be present in the lower jaw. Moving on to the canines. They are sharp and pointed teeth present on both sides of the incisors, and their function is to tear the food apart. And there are 4 canines, 2 in each jaw. 2 in each jaw. Okay, 2 in the upper jaw, 2 in the lower jaw. Then there were premolars. Premolars are flat and broad teeth. They are present next to the canines and they crush and chew the food. And there are total 8 premolars, 4 in each jaw. Then molars. At the back of each jaw, there are flat and broad teeth called molars. Now, molars are present at the very back of the mouth, okay, and they are broader than premolars. That is the difference between premolars and molars, that these molars, they are broader than premolars, okay. They help in chewing and grinding the food well. There are 12 molars, 6 in each jaw. How many molars are there? There are 12 molars, 6 in each jaw. Then we have studied about parts of a tooth. As you can see over here, two parts, our tooth is having two parts. First is the crown, second part is the root. Root part is present inside the gums. The teeth are enrooted, they are fixed in the gums of our mouth. The pink color gums, muscular portion which you can see, that is called the gum. So the white portion which is visible to us, that is known as crown, and the root portion of the teeth which is not visible to us because it is present inside the gums, that is known as root. Part of the teeth. And this crown, it is made up of enamel. It is the white substance present on the teeth, and it is the hardest substance in our body. The outermost white part of a tooth is called enamel. And below the enamel is the hard dentine. Inside dentine lies the soft pulp. Now, below the dentine or inside the dentine, there is the soft muscular portion that is called pulp. And this pulp is enriched with, it is richly supplied with blood vessels and nerves. Okay. So inside dentine lies the soft pulp. It forms the central part of a tooth. It has blood vessels and nerves. So it was about part of a tooth. Now there was one topic about taking care of our teeth, because it is also very important that we have to take very good care of our teeth. Otherwise, our teeth will become weak. It will be decayed. There will be so many teeth and gum problems if we will not take very good care of our teeth, if we will not maintain proper oral hygiene. Then some of the diseases, some of the tooth related problems also we have seen. The first was plaque. Plaque is the yellow sticky layer that is formed on the teeth. If the teeth are not cleaned properly, then germs, they can grow on them and forming a yellow sticky layer called plaque. Okay, so if you will not maintain proper cleanliness and proper hygiene of your teeth, if you will not brush your teeth properly, then what will happen? These germs, they can grow on them and they will form a yellow sticky layer, and that in scientific term is known as plaque. Now these germs, these very germs, they can change the sugar present in food particles into an acid. This acid attacks the enamel and makes a hole called cavity. Yes, now you must have listened that yes, that person is suffering from cavity, or some children, they are having cavity in their tooth. So what is that cavity? Sometimes when we eat food, sometimes, nay, most of the times when we eat food, some food particles, they remain stuck between the gaps between the teeth, And if these food particles, they are not being cleaned properly, they are not being flushed out properly, then what happen? These only germs, as I have told you, that these microorganisms, these germs, it may be present anywhere and everywhere. The thing is that they remain inactivate for most of the time, but as soon as they get suitable environmental condition or suitable kind of things in which they can grow, they can act, then they start affecting us, then they start harming us. So if the food particles, stuck food particles between our gap of our teeth is not being cleaned properly, then these germs will start attacking on the sugar present in the food particles. They will convert that sugar into acid, and acid has a corrosion effect. It can corrode anything, it can break anything. So that acid only start making holes in the teeth, and those holes are known as cavity. And when this cavity reaches the pulp region, reaches this muscular region, the central part of our tooth, it starts making cavity from the enamel. And when that cavity reaches the dentine and to the pulp region, then it starts paining. Then the tooth starts, that particular tooth starts paining, and tooth decay results in, and this tooth decay or cavity, it may also result in bad breath, toothache and indigestion. Okay, so these terms you have to pronounce, you have to learn the spellings of these little bit difficult terms. So that's why I have sent the PDF of each and every chapter, each and every topic which I am covering, so that you could read the chapters also. Reading of chapter is equally important. Okay, because 2 to 3 times reading of a chapter should be done by you. So take care of this point also. Now, ways to protect our teeth. Now, all these were problems of our teeth. Now, how we can get rid of these problems? So that's being discussed over here, that you have to brush your teeth twice a day, in morning at night. Clean both the inner and outer surfaces of teeth. Brush the upper teeth downwards and lower teeth upwards. That means upper teeth downwards and lower teeth upwards. In that both directions, you should clean up your teeth. Brush the chewing surfaces of premolars and molars. As you know, these premolars and molars, they are present at the back of our mouth. So you should take your brush to the corners of your mouth also for cleaning of them. Cleaning of these premolars and molars. Then you should rinse your mouth after every meal with water to remove food particles stuck between teeth. Now what you should do? You should rinse your mouth after every meal. Why? Because I have told you, whatever food particles remain stuck between our mouth, between the gaps of our teeth, only on that, those stuck food particles, these bacteria, these germs attack and start making acid or cavity. Okay? So you have to flush your mouth, rinse your mouth after every meal, so that if any food particle remains stuck between the gaps of your teeth, it could be flushed out. Avoid eating too many chocolate, sweets or sticky food. This may stick to teeth and cause teeth decay. Eat. And what you should eat? If you should avoid eating too many chocolate, sweets, sticky food, then you should eat fruits and raw vegetables like carrot and radish. And you should drink milk every day, because milk contains the minerals, calcium. It has lots of vitamins, proteins, that is good for the health of our teeth. Okay. And you should visit a dentist in every 6 months for the proper and regular checkup of your teeth. What is the health? What is the status? If there is any problem or not. So you should pay a visit to a dentist in every 6 months for the normal and regular checking of the health of your teeth. Then we have studied about digestive system. That we eat a variety of food every day, and these food are made up of nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals. Different food items contains different types of nutrients in them. So these nutrients are to be provided to each cells and tissues of our body. So how this thing will happen? This thing happens with the help of the process of digestion, and that digestion process is being carried out by the digestive system in our body. Okay, so the process of breaking down of food into simpler substances means into their constituent nutrients, by which nutrients those food items are made. Those food items after eating are ultimately being converted into those constituent nutrients only inside our body by the digestive system. Okay, so that is only the process of digestion. In this process, the food particles, the food items which we eat, they are ultimately, they are finally broken down into very simpler, very smaller substances or their nutrients, constituent nutrients. That is the carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals. And many organs work together to digest the food. These organs form a digestive system called, sorry, this, These organs form a organ system that is known as digestive system. Now these were the organs which I have already discussed in detail with you. First organ was mouth. The process of digestion starts in mouth. That is an important thing which you have to keep in your mind, that the process of digestion, it itself begins in mouth with your taking in food, with your chewing and biting the food. While chewing, the food is mixed with saliva, that is a liquid substance which is produced in our mouth while we chew our food, while we eat our food, and mixes with the saliva, and it also makes the food soft and moist and helps in digestion. Okay, so from mouth the food passes to esophagus or food pipe. Okay, and from the food pipe the food reaches to the stomach. In the stomach, when the food is reached, the stomach is a sac-like organ. As you can see the structure, it is a sac-like organ. It has cavity. Okay, cavity-like organ it is. Now the food from the food pipe has reached here. Partially digested food has reached here. As soon as the partially digested food reaches here, the walls of the stomach, they start secreting digestive juices to digest that reached food. Okay, and that break down the food further. Now from stomach, the food reaches to small intestine. As this is the picture of the small intestine. As soon as the food reaches from the stomach to the small intestine, it is partially digested. But the completion of digestion process occurs in small intestine. It is the only place, it is the only organ of the digestive system where the digestion of food is completed. Okay, as soon as the partially digested food reaches, partially digested means half digested food reaches from the stomach to the small intestine, the muscular walls of small intestine, they start secreting digestive juices. They start releasing some digestive juices which acts on those food items, ultimately breaking them into their constituent nutrients. And in this, liver also helps small intestine. It also produces a digestive juice called bile that helps in the digestion of food. Bile moves into the small intestine for digesting the food. When the food items reaches in a small intestine, then this is our liver. From this liver also one juice that is called bile, digestive, it is also a kind of digestive juice. It is being secreted, it is being released into this small intestine, which assists small intestine in complete digestion of food. So it is written over here, digestive juices completely digest the food now, and whatever useful nutrients are present in the digested food, they are absorbed through the walls of the small intestine into the blood, and blood carries these nutrients to all parts of the body, and from here only it is richly supplied with blood vessels. It is the nutrients, they are absorbed by the walls of the small intestine itself, and blood also absorbs these nutrients, and from here these blood distributes these nutrients to complete parts of our body so that they can carry out their normal functioning. Then sixth number was of large intestine. Food that cannot be digested in the small intestine, they comes into the large intestine, and it absorbs the water from the undigested food and form feces. Feces, I have told you, that is the solid waste produced by our body. Now whatever food remains undigested, they passes on to the large intestine, and in that large intestine, it absorbs the extra water present in the food item, and those undigested or extra or waste food items, they are being converted into solid waste or feces. And the function of anus, that is the seventh organ, is that it has to pass out the feces from the body. Feces are passed out of the body through this anus. This is the anus, last portion of the digestive system. Now we have studied certain healthy eating habits, that we should always chew the food well, eat a balanced diet to stay healthy, eat fruits and vegetables every day, drink plenty of water, always wash your hands before and after meals. So these are some healthy eating habits which you should adopt. And kids, in one of the revision video also, I will conduct one more video in which I will teach you how to do the reading of the chapter. As already I have taught you, because I have read each and every line of the book while explaining the chapters in my part 1, part 2, part 3 videos. But even then, as a recapitulation, I will make one video in which I will do reading of the chapter, reading of the sentences, reading of the lesson, and you will listen that very carefully in that session. Okay, now let's see our first book exercise. This is the only first book exercise. Now fill in the blanks with the correct words. You know how to solve fill in the blanks, as you have done in grade 3 also, that there is a statement given and one or two options are given. Now out of those two options, you have to tick, you have to write, you have to find out the correct one, the suitable one, most suitable word, which will complete the given sentence, which will make out a meaning, which will make a meaning out of the given sentence. Okay, now let's see what is the first statement. We should brush our teeth - twice or once daily. Then how many times we should brush our teeth? I have already told you that we should brush our teeth twice. One at the morning time when you get up from the bed, and one at the night time when you are going to bed. When you have taken your dinner, then you should brush your teeth. Okay, so we should brush our teeth twice daily. Next statement. The process of digestion starts in the mouth or stomach. As we have seen, that the process of digestion starts in the mouth itself, because after chewing the food, it gets mixed with saliva, and this saliva start digesting the food over here only, over in your mouth only. Okay, so this will be the correct word, that the process of digestion, it starts in the mouth. Okay, third one, - produces a digestive juice called bile. Now what is the name of the organ which produces a digestive juice called bile? It is liver or stomach. So yes, you have got it right. It is liver, because it's clearly written over here that it produces a digestive juice called bile. The name of the digestive juice which liver produces, it is known as bile. So you have to learn both the things, that liver produces the digestive juice called bile, or it could also be given in the as a blank, that liver produces a digestive juice known as - so you should learn bile. So both these things should be learned to you, that liver is the organ of the digestive system which produces the digestive juice called bile, and bile is the digestive juice which is being produced by the liver. Okay, the next statement. Feces pass out of the body through the anus or small intestine. Then we have seen over here that anus is the organ through which the feces pass out of our body. Okay, so the feces pass out of the body through the anus. We should chew our - well. How we should chew? So we should chew our food well, because water is not to be chewed, it's to be drink. It's for drinking purpose. So what is to be chewed? The food items. These food is to be chewed well. Then we have studied the topic microbes, that microbes are very tiny living things. They cannot be seen through open eyes or naked eyes, and they can only be seen through a microscope, and they are found everywhere. Some are useful, some are harmful. Now about the useful microbes also, I have told you certain names of certain microbes. These microbes or these microorganisms, they are of four types. This is bacteria, this is virus, this is fungi, this is protozoan. Bacteria causes diseases like typhoid, tuberculosis. Fungi causes diseases of skin like ringworm, athlete's foot. Viruses also cause diseases like this skin diseases, they were caused by this fungi. And these viruses, they cause diseases like polio and common cold. And protozoa, they can cause diseases like malaria and dysentery. And some microbes are useful also to us. So they are used to make bread and bun. And I have told you that this is the name of the microbe, that is yeast. And by the fermentation process, it acts on the sugar or the food items, forming carbon dioxide plus ethanol. These are name of certain chemical compounds which you will study in detail in your higher classes. Okay, right now you just need to know that, yes, what is the name of this microbe which are used to make bread and bun? So the name of the microbe is yeast. And by fermentation process, it acts on the sugar, forming carbon dioxide plus ethanol. That's why the bread and bun, they are so soft to touch and eat also. Then some microbes, they are used to make curd from milk. So which microorganism help the milk to convert into curd? The name of the microorganism is Lactobacillus bacteria. And some microbes, they help in decaying of dead plants and animals. The name of that microorganism is bacteria, fungi and earthworms. These microorganisms helps in the decomposition, in the decaying of any dead organic matter. What are the organic matter? any dead part of the living things like plant or animals. So they need to be decomposed. Okay, they need to be decayed. So which microorganism helps? So bacteria, fungi, earthworm. These are certain organisms which help in the decomposition or decaying of dead plants and animals. Now about this section, let's memorize. I have already told you can call it keywords or definitions also. This section can be called as keywords or definitions also. And your homework is to write all these keywords: temporary teeth, permanent teeth, enamel, plaque, digestion, microbes, okay, in the notebook which you are maintaining. So one more question I will discuss with you in this session, that is the tick the correct answer. So in this type of questions, one statement is given along with four different options. Out of these four options, you have to choose the most appropriate or the correct option for the given statement. So what is the first statement? How many permanent teeth are there in an adult? So it is 32, 16, 20 or 22. Yes, it is 32. So 32 permanent teeth are there in an adult. 16 in the upper jaw, 16 in the lower jaw. Second, which of the following is not a type of tooth? Crown, incisor, canine, molar. Now we all know we have studied four types of tooth. That was incisor, canine, premolar and molar. So all these are part of a tooth, but this one is odd one out. All these are types of tooth, but it is the part of a tooth. Okay, as you have seen over here, parts of a tooth, the crown and root, it comes as a part of a tooth. Each tooth has this part, this crown and root. But on the basis of their functions, what functions each teeth is performing and their shapes and size, there are four types of teeth: incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Okay, so crown is not a type of tooth, actually, it is a part of a tooth. So it is the odd one out here. Will be the correct answer for the given question. Third, how many molars are there in the upper jaw? So 12, 16, 6, and 8. So this number of teeth, each type of teeth numbers you have to keep in your mouth. Sorry, you have to keep in your mind. So how many molars are there? So 6 molars are there in the upper jaw. It is asking about upper jaw. It is not asking about the total number of molars that present in your mouth. It is only asking that how many molars are there in the upper jaw. So 6 molars are there. And in the lower jaw also 6 molars. So in total 12 molars are present. Okay. The hardest substance in our body, you all know it is enamel. Crown, root, dentine, enamel. So correct answer is enamel. As I have already told you that enamel is the hardest substance in our body. Next, last question, that is what carries food from the mouth to the stomach? So esophagus. From the mouth to the stomach, as you can see, from the mouth to the stomach, this is the connecting section that is called esophagus or food pipe. Question can come in any of the form. It can tell you to write esophagus also. It can tell you to write food pipe also. So both these terms you should learn, you should keep in your mind. Okay, so esophagus or food pipe is the part which carries food from the mouth to the stomach. So for this session of the video, this much only. I hope you have studied and understand these things properly, as we have done a quick recap type of this lesson, and two book exercises also we have discussed. That was one fill in the blanks and one tick the correct answer. And I have told you that you have to write these keywords or definitions of this lesson, that is teeth and digestive system, neatly and cleanly in your notebook in your previous class, third science notebook. Okay, you just mention in this in the last in from where you are starting the work, you just mention over there that session 2020-21 class 4th weekly homework or subject science homeworks. And then from the next page, write down date and day, write down chapter number, topic 2, name of the chapter, teeth and digestive system, draw margin line, then write down keywords and start writing these keywords neatly and cleanly. After you complete these keywords, then you can do these fill in the blanks. Okay, and this tick the correct answer. I will also post the PDF of PDF of all these book exercises and these keywords also, but you can do from YouTube lecture sessions also, and you can watch these on PDF also. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you for the class.